Good morning, students. So today we are going to start our chapter 3, Basics of Writing Program in Java. Now before starting this chapter, first whatever we have discussed about Java till now, we will recap it fast. So first we have discussed what is Java, then we discussed its features, about its types. So what is Java? Java is an object-oriented programming language and it is a platform-independent language. Now in the features, we discuss first feature, it's a platform-independent language, and another name for this feature is Vora. Vora is write once, run anywhere. Means if you are writing a program on one machine and compile it over there, you can run the same program on any other machine having any other platform. Platform is operating system. And the second feature, Java is object-oriented programming language. Then third feature we discuss, it is a case sensitive. It means capital and small letters are treated differently. It is a secure language, and then we discuss it uses Unicode character set. Then we discussed types of Java program. There are two types of Java program, application and applets. Now applications are also called standalone program. Whatever programs we will make in Java, all program will be application programs only. And application program have which method? Main method. And the execution starts with that main method only. Applets are the programs for internet purpose. That we will not do in this class. So applets are the smart programs and designed for internet purpose. After that we discussed about translators. In every high-level language, we uses either compiler or interpreter. But in Java language, we uses both translators, compiler as well as interpreter. What is the function of compiler? Compiler converts the Java program into bytecodes. And interpreter converts bytecodes into machine language. So we need both compiler as well as interpreter. Now coming to this chapter number 3, basics of writing program in Java. So as you can see on screen, one logo is there. This logo is a logo of Java. Now the next slide is Unicode character set. In the first chapter we have not discussed about it, so today we will discuss what are Unicode character set. See, when you press any key on keyboard, your system gives you assigns a code for the storage purpose. Like when you press capital A, the system assigns 65. For B, the code is 66, and so on. You might have heard about ASCII code. ASCII code also assign the code, but they are limited in number. They can assign code only for 128 characters. So ASCII code are used for limited characters, and in Java we prefer Unicode character set over the ASCII code. Why? Because they are used for coding for numerous characters of different scripts. So many languages we use on computer system. For the other languages also, it provides the codes. So in Unicode character set, it provides how many codes? It can provide codes for 160,755 characters. So Unicode represents a higher range of codes over the ASCII code. So Unicode include ASCII code. So Unicode has a higher range as compared to the ASCII code. So this is the purpose of using Unicode character set in Java. I hope it is clear. Now you can see Java application program on a screen. The first line, this is called comment. The line starting with a backslash, this is called comment. Now every application program we make within class. So for every program we will make class, and as it is case sensitive, the first letter of class will be small, C will be small, and the class name first letter will be capital. So you need to learn or remember these things. Class C will be small and the first letter of class name will be capital. Then this is the opening braces of the class. Then main method. I told you in application program always there will be main method from which the execution will start. So how will you represent main method? Public static void main. This the syntax you need to learn. Every word has its own meaning, but here I will not increase the complexity by explaining each and every word. We will discuss the meaning of each and every word in the coming chapters. So here you will see only public static void main string as capital args. Args is a array. Then these are the bracket. So you need to learn this syntax. We will always use this syntax in every program. So this is the main method. Then we have take this is the opening bracket of main method. This is the opening bracket of class. This is the opening bracket of main method. Now the next, what we have done, we have declared the variables. This is the declaration of variable A, B, C. There are three variables in which we have assigned value 10, 15 and 0. And the what is int? Int is the type of variable. This is called data type. Then C equals to A plus B. And to print the value of C, we will use system.out.println. This also we will discuss in the coming chapters. Now here we are concerned about these lines, comment and data type, int and variable. So these three things we will discuss. Now first is comment. The first line in a program should be a comment line. Always the first line in a, like in QBasic we have done. The first line was the comment, and to represent comment, which command we used? Rem command. In the same way in Java, we used to write comment by using the double slash. So first line in a program should be a comment line for the program description. Now it is used to give additional information about the program. Why do we use comment? It is used to give additional information, and it is a non-executable statement. Compiler will ignore this statement. Compiler will not execute this comment. Now two types of comments you can give in Java. Single line comment and the multi-line comment. Single line comment you give with the help of two backslashes. Like this is example program written by Priya, then is preceded with double slash. And the multi-line comment you can give with this slash star, and you will close the comment with again asterisk slash. For example, you have started the comment with backslash asterisk program written by Sumit and program written on 15th April. So here there are two lines. And for multi-line we use this backslash asterisk and close with asterisk backslash. So these are the two different types of comments. Now after comment we will discuss data type. Now in program we have noticed that, again I am showing you, this is a comment and here this is the data type. Fine. So now we are going to discuss what are data type. Data type indicates type of values that we can use in our program. So value we have taken there 10. So what type of value it is? Integer type. So data type, what data type is telling you? That the value which you have taken is of integer type, that is whole number. So it indicates type of values that we can use in our program. And second, it also specifies the amount of memory space and the range of numbers. Amount of by integer, you will be able to know that it will occupy the space 4 bytes. Now I will show you the in next slides that for integer, it will compiler allocate space in memory of 4 byte. Fine. So it will tell you amount of memory space and the range of number. Okay, I'm showing here. This is the table. See, when you declare any variable with any data type like int, can you see int here? Int. So if you are declaring any variable with int data type, how much size it is? 4 byte. The 4 byte space will be reserved, will be allocated in memory to store its value. And what range of value you can give? You can give any number between this to this, negative to positive, because integer includes all negative as well as positive number. So this is the range of integer. Now why do we want to declare the data type? Why do we need to declare? See, if you want to use small number like 10, 12, so it will come in this range, minus 128 to 127, and it occupies space 1 byte. So you should declare that variable with byte instead of int. Why? Because if you are using byte, the space will be allocated 1 byte. But if you are using integer for 10 or 12 small number, then it will occupy space 4 byte. The space will be wasted. So for optimum utilization of memory space, it is better to declare the data type. Fine. So for optimum utilization of memory space, we declare the data type of variable. If the number is small, we should prefer byte short. If the number is long, like in this range it comes, so we should prefer integer or long. So all these are integer type. We will come again in this slide. So again I am going back. So data type, I hope it is clear. What is the use of data type? Here in the program, int a equals to 10. So what is int? Int is a data type. A is the variable and 10 is the value. So why, when you see the int, automatically it will come in your mind that the value will be integer type. And how much space it will occupy in the memory? It 4 byte. And what range you can allocate here? What are the numbers which you can allocate here in A? So there are 2 points. It indicates types of value that we can use in our program. And second is, it also specifies the amount of memory space and the range of number. So this is data type. Now data type again is of two type: primitive data type and non-primitive data type. Primitive data type, again, two categories: numeric type, non-numeric type. In numeric, integer, floating, character, boolean. The chart which we have which I have just shown you, that is of primitive data type. This one. This is the chart of primitive data type. In primitive data type, two types categories are there. Numeric include integer types and floating point types, and non-numeric includes character type and boolean type. Okay, now come to the what are primitive data type. Primitive data type, also called basic data type, these are predefined or built-in data type. It can store only one value of that data type. These are called basic data type, and these are inbuilt. Inbuilt means it was declared at the time of development of Java. So Java developers have defined these data types. So these are called inbuilt or predefined. Now it can store only one value of that data type. What does it mean? Like int x equals to 100. This is correct. But if you write int x equals to 100 comma 10, that will be wrong, because you can assign only one value at one time. In a one variable, you can assign only one value. You cannot assign two values. 100 comma 5, you cannot assign in x. Fine. Now the second type, non-primitive data type. Non-primitive data type, also known as reference data type, these are created from primitive and other non-primitive data type. The first point, these are called reference data type, and these are created from primitive data type. I will give you example. See, in non-primitive data type, there is a class string, 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 and string is a group of characters. And what are characters? Char type, primitive type. So string here, group of character, it means this non-primitive data type is created from primitive data type, because char is a primitive data type and string is a group of character. So we can say non-primitive data types are created from primitive and other non-primitive data type. Fine. Now in non-primitive data type, different types of categories are there, like string, array, interface is also there, but we are concerned in this book only string. So we will discuss only string. And what is a string? String is a group of characters. Like India, how many characters are there? 5 characters, 2020, 4 characters, and this is also a string. String can include alphabets, digits, or any symbol. And it always represented by within double quotes. Fine. So these are the some features of non-primitive data type. Now this table is very, very important. The question might can come. First we will understand this table. Primitive data type. There are two types of primitive data type, numeric and non-numeric. Numeric includes integer and floating point types, and non-numeric character type and boolean type. In integer type, there are four categories: byte, short, int, long. Byte data types occupies how much space? 1 byte, short 2, int 4, long 8. Now what does it mean? It means if you are declaring a variable with this data type, like byte a equals to 10. What does it mean? A is a variable of byte data type, and it will occupy space in memory of 1 byte, and the range of value you can assign is -128 to 127. It means in byte a you can assign 10, you can assign 100, and you can assign 127 also. So within this range you can assign value to the variable a of if it is of byte type. Now come to the short type. The range will be increasing. As you can see, after bike, the short it is, the range will be increasing and the size also increasing. So in short, if you are declaring a variable with short data type, like short c equals to any number, you can give 10,000 if you are giving, you can give. So if you are taking short c equals to 10,000, then it will come in the range 10,000. And how much space will be allocated for short 2 bytes? For integer, int type, the range will be large, very large. Now any number within this range you can assign in int variable. In data type, like int c, any number you can assign from this range and it will occupy space 4 bytes. And for long it is, again the range is very very large. Now you have to learn that integer types having 4 categories, byte, short, int, long, and its sizes are 1, 2, 4, 8. You have to learn this. And the range also you need to mug up. Range can also be asked. How much space, if the variable is declared int, what is the range of that, it can be asked. So you need to learn range and its size. Now floating point type contains decimal number. Again, it contains two categories, float, double, sizes 4 and 8. This is the range. Fine. Character type, only one category, char type. And the first letter of primitive data type will always be small. Then char, it occupies space 2 bytes. And how do you represent char? Within single quotes. Then boolean type. Boolean type category is boolean, b will be small, and the value is either true or false. So these are the primitive data type. So that's it for today. So you will read